I went to multiple stores and Amazon to get 5 different types of sticky tack to put them head to head so you know what the best type of sticky tack is once and for all. Before we get started, what is sticky tack? Sticky tack in animation is used to hold your characters in midair, on the platform, or maybe just help them be attached to an item. Basically, it's an all-around really helpful substance that will just improve your animation if you use it with like Legos and other plastic animation things. It's also used for hanging posters and I've been using Yoohoo Tack for many years. It's very flexible, very good to the feel, all around good substance, not greasy, not slimy, and not powdery. Yoohoo Tack Pro Power, which is supposed to be an extra strong Yoohoo Tack. It's a lot more dense and it's harder to pull on, so it has less flexibility, so it's okay. Gorilla Mounting Putty, it's very similar to Yoohoo. It might have a little more strength to it and just a tad bit more stretch to it. But as you can see here, I'm really struggling to pull it apart, which is super good for stop motion. Jot Poster Tack I got from Dollar Tree, and it's greasy. It's greasy right out of the package. It's, you can see my fingerprints on it. Don't steal my identity, please. It's kind of gross. It's kind of stretchy, but it pulls, if you pull it too hard, it'll just break really fast. The stretchiness is actually bad in this case because if you pull it too far, it'll go thin and be more like silly putty than tack. Tacky from Hobby Lobby let's just say it's different. It's got a weird powdery texture and it's like it's got lumps of, I don't know, baking soda or flour inside of it. I don't know what tack's made out of, but it's not that. It's kind of dry. And it's not super stretchy. Once you knead it and get it really hot, it stretches better, but it breaks pretty easily. Test number one, attachment endurance. For this test, I'm attaching Lego bricks together with little dabs of sticky tack, and I'm gonna leave it there for about 12 hours to see, will it hold up on the wall that long?
12 hours later.
So initially we see that somewhere during the night, the Hobby Lobby brand fell off and it's got a weird texture the way it fell off. It's like it just dried out around itself and just collapsed. Test two, removability cleanliness. I'm gonna pull them off here. The poster tack left kind of a big blob on the brick here, as you can see. Not super good for pulling it straight off. The mounting putty pulled off pretty cleanly, and it's still really usable and really intact. The Yoohoo Pro Power, it pulled off, it's pretty clean on both sides, it just stuck to the wall more than the brick. The regular Yoohoo, very clean, very predictable. As you can see, I pulled it off the wall here and it pulled off without any residue at all. Test number three, practical animation test. The minifigure weighs about 3 grams, so I put him on a helping hand with a little dab of sticky tack, a realistic amount that you might use for animating a walk cycle in midair if you're gonna do that. I animated like a short little walk cycle in midair, both legs, both arms animated, and I did this for all the tacks, and I wanted to see if it was gonna fall off during animation. Yoohoo regular sticky tack stuck really well. Yoohoo Pro Power, the same, kind of a pain I thought to get it stuck initially though. Gorilla Mounting Putty, basically the same as the Yoohoo Tack. It was very nice. Dollar Tree Poster Tack, not great. It kept sagging. And it was really soft, as you can see. If it pulls off, it kind of just stretches with it, which you might be thinking is good, but not in this application. It's not very good. It was saggy. Hobby Lobby Tack really had a hard time getting stuck on there because it doesn't have much, I don't know, oil in it. So it was really hard to get it stuck. And once I did get it stuck, it was just a saggy and it just kept going. And eventually it would have fallen off if I hadn't stopped it because it's just not great. Too dry. As you can see, I even try to push it back and immediately it never holds its shape. Test number four, stretch slash weight resistance. For this test, I'm using a 4-pound weight and I'm gonna drop it on my feet, I mean on the table. I wrapped the sticky tack firmly around the handle and then grabbed it on the opposite axis so that would give it a fair shot. As you can see, the Yoohoo performed pretty well, a slow fall. It held its own pretty great. The Pro Power, it was okay. It didn't stretch out as badly as the regular Yoohoo, but eventually it did snap. Gorilla mounting putty was pretty strong, it went down pretty slowly, until it snapped a little bit at the end. Poster Tack just stretched out of shape, and it just kept stretching, and it just kept stretching, and it got on my 3D printer, and it got on my clothes. Hobby Lobby Tacky just failed completely. I thought it was gonna break the table. It just did not hold at all. I even gave it a second chance. It's bad. Test 5.
Oh,
I'm using a hairdryer to... Just a second. Let me turn this off.
Oftentimes when you're animating, the lights will be hot or the room will be warm, and if the sticky tack is losing its integrity with the heat, the character might sag or might not stick to the platform or might stick too much to something, and that's really bad. I'm using a hairdryer to heat up the sticky tack. As you can see, I got it up to 159.6 degrees Fahrenheit. Pretty hot. The Yoohoo tack lost a lot of its structural integrity. It was very mushy, but it was still pretty sticky as you could see from the residue it left. The Pro Power handled better under heat. It didn't fall apart as badly, although it wasn't as stretchy, it was more chunky. The Gorilla, very stretchy, very stringy. The Dollar Tree actually kind of lost some of its stringiness. It got more chunky when it got heated up. I'm not sure how that works, but still very nasty to the touch. The Hobby Lobby peels right off, but the texture is still super weird. It doesn't string out at all. Even under the heat, I thought it would string out more, but nope, not at all. Test 7.
I can't make that sound effect with my mouth.
Ching! As you can see, I've organized these by the same order I've used them so far, with the price being dollars and the grams being the weight of the package that it comes in. Sorting that by price per gram reveals that the Dollar Tree at $1.25 was only about 2 cents per gram. However, the Yoohoo Tack, which was $3 for a pack and came with 60 grams, was only 5 cents per gram, which to be fair is more than double the price. But the most expensive by far was the Yoohoo Pro Power. It cost about $8.50 for only 50 grams, which is way less than even the Yoohoo regular brand had in its package, at a whole 16 cents per gram. A stark difference of over 3 times as much as the regular Yoohoo. Here are my rankings. Number 1, Yoohoo. Pretty inexpensive. Good texture and strength. Doesn't leave a ton of residue. However, it's hard to find locally, had to get it on Amazon. By far my favorite, slightly biased probably because I've been using it for over 9 years. Gorilla mounting putty. Really strong. It didn't sacrifice a lot of stretchiness though. It wasn't super dense. It was a good texture. The cons, there was a lot in that one pack. It's a lot of upfront cost. But you can also share it with your mom, so. Third place, Yoohoo Tack Pro Power. The pros were it's very strong, it's dark. The dark color is really good for hiding it on set. The cons, a lot. It's not that strong, not significantly strong enough to counteract the price. Dollar Tree Jot Poster Tack. It's really cheap at only $1.25, easily available. There's probably 4 or 5 Dollar Trees where you live, which is crazy because they seem like they're always going out of business. The cons, it's so greasy, it's yucky, it's nasty, it's way too stretchy, got all over my clothes. It's more like silly putty than sticky tack in a way. Not worth it. I wish I had my $1.25 back. And I wish I didn't have to stand in line for 20 minutes to get this thing. Hobby Lobby Tacky. Don't waste your money. This thing costs so much for so little, I'm going to throw it away. It's dry, it's got a nasty texture, it's like chunky so it doesn't really want to grip onto anything. It's got very little stretch, it kind of just breaks apart, doesn't last very long, gets dried out than any of the others over time. I left these on my desk for like a month and it basically just turned into crustiness. It also pulled off my drywall and it melted to rubber for some reason. Also, it was really inconsistent in its quality in the store. I found it where it was kind of brown and even drier in the back of the store. I used the white one for the benefit of the doubt, but clearly it doesn't hold up very well over time. And there you go. This is an extremely niche video, but maybe you were interested in it and maybe it helped you out. So let me know what brand you like if I didn't review it, or if I did, do let me know in the comments. And if you'd like any more reviews or tutorials or whatever you want to see from me that I can make, or maybe I can't make. But tell me anyway, in the comments below, like, comment, and please subscribe for more.
Thank you.